Hey, Ryan here with AlarmSystemStore.com. I've been getting a lot of phone calls recently with people who own DSC alarm systems and they have a trouble light on their system. Orange triangle, orange LED light. Some people, it may appear yellow too. That is a trouble light. And I am going to show you an easy way on how you can figure out what that trouble light is. I'm also going to post a link right below me, which will take you to a PDF file that is a troubleshooting guide for the DSC alarm systems. I'm going to show you the power series hardwired systems, the 1616, 1832, 1864 troubleshooting guide. However, if you have the wireless alarm systems, the DSC Alexor or the Impasa, this troubleshooting guide will work for that as well. If you have an installation manual, this guide is in the back of every single installation manual. So let's go over to my desk. I've got a keypad set up. I've got a trouble light, couple trouble lights on it actually. And I will show you how to follow through on this guide and figure out what's wrong with your alarm system. Okay, so here I am at my table. I have my troubleshooting guide for the DSC Power Series systems. And as you can see, this is going to tell you how to figure out what is wrong with your system if you have the orange triangle light or the orange LED light. In the beginning, if you can print this off our webpage, the link was below. You can see that it says LCD programmable message keypad. Press star 2 to view trouble condition. The trouble light will flash. It's going to display the first trouble condition. You can use the arrow keys to scroll through. If you've got a keypad like a 5501 that just displays numbers, that will display. Here you can see if light 1 is displayed, it's service required. You can hit 1 for more information, and it's going to tell you the numbers or the lights that continue to stay on, what the issue is. I've got two keypads here. I've got my 5500 fully alpha programmable keypad, and I have a 5501 to the right, which is just a fixed English keypad. I've got both keypads set up so that way you can see the difference. You can see on both keypads that there is orange triangle light on both of them. And I am going to see what the trouble light is on these. So if you got the troubleshooting guide, just look right at it. You're going to hit star 2. And I have a 1 and 3. Well, I look over at my sheet. It tells me to press 1 for more information since I have a 1 up there. And it's going to show me 1 and 2. So under number 1, I see 1 means a low battery. And 2 means bell circuit. That just means I don't have a siren and I don't have a resistor in the bell circuit. And 1 low battery, I simply do not have a battery connected to this panel. Or if you do have a battery connected, it's time to replace the main control panel's battery. I'll exit out of that. I'll hit pound a couple times. I'm going to hit star 2 again. And this time 3. And you can see 3, and if I look over at my sheet, it says telephone line trouble, which simply means that my system lost the telephone line. It's not recognizing a telephone line. This will happen if you've got a regular POTS line. A lot of times in the middle of the night, 2-3 o'clock in the morning, they'll reset the phone lines, and your system will detect that and will start beeping at you. The keypad beeping in the middle of the night, beep, 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 which can be very, very annoying. So you've seen that on the 5501. Move over here to the 5500. If I hit star 2, service required, hit star, low battery, arrow keys, I can scroll, bell circuit, press the pound to exit. Arrow keys here shows there's more, you know, phone line, press pound to exit. Sometimes you will get a number 8 that pops up. And what 8 simply means is loss of time. Usually if you power down your system, you will not lose any programming. However, you will lose the date and time. So when you power back up, you just have to set your date and time. that is how simple it is to figure out what is wrong with your DSC system. Once again, you will want to print off one of these troubleshooting guides. We have it on our website in the knowledge base section. Or if you have an installation manual, they are in the back of every installation manual. This also goes the same for the DSC wireless systems, the Impasa and the Alexor. Any of the systems, if you're working with, pay close attention to the troubleshooting guide, because if it shows a certain number, it's going to tell you to press that number again to see what's wrong. One of the ones that a lot of people miss is light number 7, or the number 7 showing, which is a wireless device low battery. You actually have to go into that to figure out which device has a low battery simply by pressing 7 again. The first time you press 7, it's going to show you any wireless zones that have a low battery. If you hit 7 again, it's going to show you any wireless keychain remotes that have a low battery. And if you press 7 again, it's going to show you any wireless keypads that have a low battery. So you actually have to hit some numbers multiple times to see what it is. It's going to break it down to you. But if you follow that troubleshooting guide, it's going to make it a lot easier to figure out what is wrong with your system. So as you can see, as long as you have that guide, it's going to be fairly easy to figure out what is wrong with your DSC system. If you need replacement parts or anything like that, feel free to give me a call. Anyone in our tech support or sales support office will be able to help you out, and we'll get you the stuff that you need to get your system working again and get that orange trouble light off. Give us a call at 888-811-0727 or check us out online at www.alarmsystemstore.com. Until next time, I'm Ryan with Alarm System Store.